أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
الحمد لله، الحمد لله وكفى، والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى، خصوصا على افضلهم وخاتم النبيين محمد الامين وعلى اله وصحبه اجمعين. اما بعد، قد قال الله تبارك وتعالى كما ورد في سورة التوبة، اعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا ايها النبي جاهد الكفار والمنافقين واغلظ عليهم ومأواهم جهنم وبئس المصير. صدق الله العظيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. اللهم ربنا الهمنا رشدنا واعذنا من شرور انفسنا. اللهم ارنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه، وارنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم وفقنا لما تحب وترضى. اللهم انا نعوذ بك من النفاق والرياء. اللهم طهر قلوبنا من النفاق، واعمالنا من الرياء، والسنتنا من الكذب، واعيننا من الخيانه، فإنك تعلم خائنة الأعين وما تخفي الصدور. آمين يا رب العالمين. Dear brothers and sisters and sons and daughters of Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. By the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are starting with ayah number 73 of Surah At-Tawbah today. I've just recited the ayah to you. This is one of the very few ayat of the Qur'an which appear repeatedly in the Qur'an in exactly the same words. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّبِيُّ جَاهِدِ الْكُفَّارَ وَالْمُنَافِقِينَ وَاغْلُظْ عَلَيْهِمْ وَمَأْوَاهُمْ جَهَنَّمْ وَبِئْسَ الْمَصِيرُ. This ayah appears in Surah At-Tahrim also. Ayah number 8 of Surah At-Tahrim, exactly the same words, without the difference of a dot or a jot, nothing of difference at all. Now I told you that one of the main themes of Surah At-Tawbah and one of the main purposes of the expedition of Tabuk were to expose the Munafiqeen now, because it was now late, you know, it was 9th year after Hijrah, and the mission of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam had already been accomplished as far as the Arabian Peninsula was concerned. Allah's deen was dominant. So now it was high time to expose this fifth columnist part of the society, section of the society, element of the society. So they were, number one, they were exposed because, you know, it was made obligatory for every mu'min to participate in this expedition. This was the first time. Before that, it was all persuasion. Persuasion, persuasion. Ya ayyuha an-nabiyyu, harrizil mu'minina 'alal qital. You motivate them, exhort them. It's better for them to go and fight for the cause of Allah. They will get the reward, you know, in the hereafter. They should rest assured. But it was not made obligatory for every mu'min to go with the Prophet or out, you know, to fight for the cause of Allah. This was the first time. This we call Nafir-e-Aam. Every Muslim had to go. Now, whosoever didn't go, he was exposed in the first instance. Then there were people who made very lame excuses. Now, Muslims knew in this society what they are saying, it is not correct. So, even though the Prophet ﷺ accepted their lame excuses, okay, if it is so, okay, you are exempted. But you know the people around, the neighbors, they knew what your Bhaiwar is saying is wrong. He's healthy and he's resourceful. He can spend money, everything. There's no impediment in his way. So people came to know of those people, you know, who were the liars, who were not sincere in their iman. This way they were exposed. Number two, you will find these harsh words now here for munafiqeen, and the harshest also will come in this very discourse. And that is, Ya ayyuhan nabiyyu jahidil kuffara wal munafiqeen waghluz alayhim. As I told you many a time, that as far as this world is concerned, the munafiqeen are bracketed with mu'mineen. Ya ayyuhal ladheena amanu. They were also legal Muslims. But in this ayah, in this world also, they have been bracketed with kuffar. O Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, strive hard against the unbelievers, disbelievers, the rejectors of the faith, as well as these hypocrites. Waghluz alayhim, and be harsh to them. You are lenient by very nature, but you shouldn't be lenient to them. Now, because it's the matter of the deen of Allah, so you have to be harsh to them. وَمَا وَاهُمْ جَهَنَّمْ, and their abode is the hell. وَبَيْسَ الْمَسِيرُ, and it's a very bad and evil destination. This ayah, as I told you, is repeated in Surah At-Tahrim in exactly the same verse. يَحْلِفُونَ بِاللَّهِ مَا قَالُوا. They are swearing by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that they didn't so, they didn't say so. But these things are not detailed here. We find these things in Surah Al-Munafiqun, you know, in the 28th section, 28th part of Quran al-Majid. The two sayings which are given over there, يَقُولُونَ لَئِن رَجَعْنَا إِلَى الْمَدِينَةِ لَيُخْرِجَنَّ الْعَزُّ مِنْهَا الْأَزَلُ وَلِلَّهِ الْعِزَّةُ وَلِرَسُولِهِ وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَلَكِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. So that these were some of the sayings of these people. Abdullah ibn Ubayy, we shall read them inshallah when we reach there. But when explanation was called, did you say so? They said, no, my God, I swear by Allah, I never said so. He must have misunderstood. Or he is a mischief monger, whosoever has, you know, conveyed it to you. يَحَلِفُونَ بِاللَّهِ مَا قَالُوا وَلَقَدْ قَالُوا كَلِمَةَ الْكُفْرِ. They have actually said and uttered those words which amount to blasphemy. وَكَفَرُوا بَعْدَ إِسْلَامِهِمْ. And they have really returned to kufr after their Islam. Now, here the word Islam is used, not iman. Legal Islam, that is the cover. Although they have this cover over them to hide their hypocrisy, but beneath this cover, they have actually gone back to kufr. وَكَفَرُوا بَعْدَ إِسْلَامِهِ وَهَمُّوا بِمَا لَمْ يَنَالُوا. And they tried what they couldn't achieve. This refers to an incident that when on his way back to Medina from Tabuk, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was passing through a narrow valley, very narrow, very narrow. There, you know, some hypocrites, they hid and they assaulted Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because the valley was very narrow. You know, the formation was very narrow. Cylinder formation. Not many people going side by side. So at that time, some of these munafiqeen, they attacked and assaulted him. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved him. So they did it. They also knew that now, you know, our end is near. We are being exposed. And the attitude is going to be now strict. All the leniency that we have been enjoying of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it seems, you know, that period is going to end now. So they also tried, you know, their final act of trying to assassinate Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam while on his way back to Medina. وَهَمُّوا بِمَا لَمْ يَنَالُوا. They tried it, what they didn't achieve. وَمَا نَقَمُوا إِلَّا أَنْ أَغْنَاهُمُ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ. And they were not avenging of anything except that Allah and His Messenger have made them rich by the bounty of Allah. Why? You know, because one of the items on which zakah can be spent was وَالْمُؤَلَّفَةَ قُلُوبِهِمْ. So to soften the hearts of people, you know, who are important, who hold important positions in the society, and if, you know, they oppose, they can do much mischief. So zakah was given to them. And these people, some of the chiefs, you know, these munafiqeen of Aus and Khadraj, they had enjoyed that position. So by having that money from zakah, now they had become rich. Now they are avenging, because Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have made them rich out of the bounty of Allah, min fadlihi. فَمَا نَقَمُوا إِلَّا نَغْنَاهُمُ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ فَإِنْ يَتُوبُوا يَكُ خَيْرًا لَهُمْ. Now if they repent and mend their ways, it will be better for them. وَيَتَوَلَّوْا. And if they turn away, if they continue the attitude that they have been taking up till now, يُعَذِّبْهُمُ اللَّهُ عَذَابًا أَلِيمًا فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ. Now Allah will give them very painful torment and chastisement in this world also and in akhirah, in hereafter also. وَمَا لَهُمْ مِنَ الْأَرْضِ مِنْ وَلِيٍّ وَلَا نَصِيرٍ. And there is none in the whole of the earth who can be their protector or helper. So this is a very stern warning. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ عَهَدَ اللَّهُ. Now these three ayat, 75, 76, 78, 77, they also apply 100% to the Pakistani Muslim Ummah, 100%. And they are very important, very important. A certain type of hypocrites, they are being described here. There were different types of hypocrites, different levels, different grades, different types. Now, one particular type of hypocrites, they are being diagnosed here. What was the reason? Why they became munafiq? وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ عَاهَدَ اللَّهِ. Among them are those who had a covenant with Allah. لَيْنْ عَتَانَا مِنْ فَضْلِهِ. If Allah gives us from His bounty, He makes us rich, wealthy, لَنَصَّدَّقَنَّ. We shall give charities and alms, and we shall spend that money for the pleasure of Allah. وَلَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. And we shall be most pious and righteous people. Now the second ayah, فَلَمَّا آتَاهُمْ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ. When Allah gave them from His bounty, made them rich, wealthy, بَخِلُوا بِهِ. Now they acted miserly with it, niggardly with it. They closed the doors of their safes, holding, وَتَوَلَّوْا. And they turned their faces. وَهُمْ مُعْرِضُونَ. And they were averse. فَآقَبَهُمْ نِفَاقًا. Now this آقَبَ, عُقُوبَت, شَدِيدُ الْعِقَاب. This is a punishment. So Allah punished them. فَآقَبَهُمْ نِفَاقًا فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ. And this is a punishment that nifaq, the seeds of nifaq and hypocrisy have been sowed in their hearts. This is the punishment that they have got in this world. فَآقَبَهُمْ نِفَاقًا فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ إِلَىٰ يَوْمَ يَلْقَوْنَهُ. I shiver at these words when I apply these words to the Pakistani Muslim nation. May Allah save us from that. That this nifaq will remain until they meet their Lord on the Day of Judgment. They will not be rid of it. فَعَقَبَهُمْ نِفَاقًا فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ يَوْمَ يَلْقَوْا إِلَىٰ يَوْمَ يَلْقَوْنَهُ بِمَا أَخْلَفُ اللَّهَ مَا وَعَدُوهُ. Due to their going back on their words, the weak promise they had made with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَبِمَا كَانُوا يَكْزِبُونَ. And because of their telling the lie, they never intended what they were saying at that time. لَا تَعَنَ اللَّهُ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ لَا تَصَّدَّقَنَّ وَلَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. These words are 100% applicable to the Muslim Ummah. We prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At least I was. In my early youth, I was a high school student. When I was an active worker of Muslim Students Federation. I was also a worker of Pakistan movement. I was General Secretary of Hisar District Muslim Students Federation. One of the two delegates who went to the conference, very big conference which was held in Lahore, Habibiya Hall of Islamia College in 1946, in which from every district of Punjab only two delegates were invited, and I was one of the two from the district of Hisar, which is now in Haryana. So we know how we were praying, crying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, "Oh Allah, save us. Deliver us from the slavery of the Britishers and also save us from the coming slavery of the Hindus. And we shall establish your deen. We shall make Pakistan, you know, a cradle of Islamic civilization, a lighthouse, an example for the whole of humanity that this is the just social order. This is the real mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has given the just social order. The political socio-economic system based on justice, fair play, equity. That is it. So that is the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He gave this just social order through Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But what we have done, we went back upon our words. We took to the luxuries, only worldly pursuits. So this is going back on the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I have written a book, Istiqam-e-Pakistan, and I have proved that it was just a miracle, establishment of Pakistan, coming into being of Pakistan. Nobody could hope it. Even the topmost Muslim League leaders, they thought that this is just a bargaining tactic. We are demanding this, but maybe we settle for less. And Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah settled for less when he accepted the cabinet mission plan, that India will remain one, it will be composed of three zones with one central government. Three zones will be there for 10 years. But after 10 years, every zone will have a right to secede. That was the plan for at least 10 years. Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah had gone back from his demand of an independent Pakistan. But Allah gave, no, take independent Pakistan. فَنَنْظُرَ كَيْفَ تَعْمَلُونَ. Then we shall see what you do, whether you prove true to your words or you go back. Now what is this nifaq that we are having today? Number one, which I call nifaq-e-bahami, disunity. Nifaq. The nation dissolved into nationalities. It was one nation. Now it stands dissolved and divided into nationalities. And number two, the crisis of moral values. There are two ahadiths, very important. Both are muttafaqun alayh. According to the one, the Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is narrated by Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, ayatul munafiq salasun, idha haddasa kathiba, wa idha waada akhlafa, wa idha tumina khana. These are the three signs, three symptoms of the disease of nifaq. Whenever he speaks, he tells a lie. Whenever he makes a promise, he breaks it. Whenever he is trusted, he betrays the trust. And you know, this hadith in the Sahih of Imam Muslim has additional words. وَإِنْ صَامَ وَصَلَّى وَزَعَمَ أَنَّهُ مُسْلِمٌ. If such a person, he prays, and he, you know, keeps fast, and he thinks himself to be a Muslim, but he is a munafiq 100%. And we can look to our society. Whosoever is, however, how much higher he is placed, the more he is dishonest, the more he is a liar, the more important amongst, the more important people are, the more they are, they have these three qualities. So this is actually the diagnosis. Fihi zikrukum. There's an ayah in Surah Al-Anbiya. We have sent down our book. And in this book, your mention is also present. And there's the hadith from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, narrated by Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an, that the Prophet once said, there's going to be a very big tribulation, very big fitna. Innaha satakunu fitna. Ali says, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, I asked, mal makhraju minha ya Rasulullah? What will be the way out? What will be the exit from that fitna? And then the Prophet replied, Kitabullah, fihi khabaru ma qablakum wa nabau ma ba'dakum wa hukmu ma bainakum. The only way to get out from fitna is this Book of Allah. It contains the news of the people who were before you. And it contains the news of those who will be coming after you. And it contains the judgment and final word, final verdict in all the disputes which may arise among you. So these three ayat, every Pakistani Muslim should make it a point to remember them. Because they 100% apply to us, not to other countries. Other countries existed as such before they were taken by the colonialists. Then, you know, they were just freed. But Pakistan's case is absolutely different. It was a new country which came into existence. So actually, and it was established in the name of Islam. Pakistan ka matlab kya? La ilaha illallah. What does Pakistan mean? There's no God except Allah. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ آهَدَ اللَّهِ لَئِنْ آتَانَا مِنْ فَضْلِهِ لَنَصَّدَّقَنَّ وَلَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ فَلَمَّا آتَاهُمْ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ بَخِلُوا بِهِ وَتَوَلَّوا وَهُمْ مُعْرِضُونَ فَعَاقَبَهُمْ نِفَاقًا فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ إِلَى يَوْمَ يَلْقَوْنَهُ. Allah, may Allah forbid. May Allah, you know, deliver us from this at least. We, you know, pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not إِلَى يَوْمَ يَلْقَوْنَهُ. He should give us the courage to get out of this hypocrisy. بِمَا أَخْلَفُ اللَّهَ مَا وَعَدُوهُ وَبِمَا كَانُوا يَكْذِبُونَ أَلَمْ يَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَعْلَمُ سِرَّهُمْ وَنَجْوَاهُمْ نَجْوَاهُمْ. Don't they know that Allah knows what is hidden in their hearts and chests, and what they do when they are, you know, counseling privately, najwa, secret counseling, secret meetings, secret plannings. وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَّامُ الْغُيُوبِ. And verily and certainly, Allah knows all the unseens. الَّذِينَ يَلْمِذُونَ الْمُطَوِّعِينَ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ فِي الصَّدَقَاتِ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَجِدُونَ إِلَّا جُهْدَهُمْ فَيَسْخَرُونَ مِنْ سَخِرَ اللَّهُ مِنْهُمْ وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. Now another two-pronged attack of these hypocrites on the Muslims. Those who defame those people from among the Muslims who voluntarily give and contribute money. Because it's a very well-known fact of the history and seerah that before commencing the journey of Tabuk, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked for donations. A general appeal. It is going to be a very big expedition. 3,000 people are moving. 30,000. So all the, you know, rations are required and all the things, and then arms are required. So contribute, whatsoever you can. And you know, Hazrat Abu Bakr contributed everything. Left nothing at home, nothing. Not even a needle, everything he contributed. Hazrat Umar, he, you know, divided all his belongings into two parts, and in one part he contributed. But you know, when Muslims were bringing all these things, now these felt, you know, very sorry that they couldn't do it. These munafiqeen. But they used to pass remarks. Oh, yes. Yes. They want to show off. They want, you know, to show off to the people that they are very philanthropist. So that was one-sided. On the other side, there were Muslims who were very poor, who could donate much. There was one Sahabi who worked for the whole night as a laborer for a Jew. He was, you know, getting out water from the well and irrigating his garden. And in the morning he got some dates as the reward, as the wage of the night labor, divided into two parts. Half of it he gave it to the family and half he brought to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now on them they mocked. Oh yes, without this expedition could not be undertaken. Yes. This is most important. So they were attacking the Muslims both ways. Those who were contributing generously, they are showing off. And those who brought such meager contribution, without that actually, it's very correct. This expedition couldn't be undertaken without this. But what was the action of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? He said, okay, you spread all these dates over the whole of this heap. In the balance of Allah, they carry more weight than all this heap. Because it is actually the intention that Allah sees. What are the intentions? His weighing is different from our weighing. His weighing standard is different. الَّذِينَ يَلْمِزُونَ الْمُطَوِّعِينَ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. On the one side, they defame them and slander them that they are showing off. فِي الصَّدَقَاتِ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَجِدُونَ إِلَّا جُهْدَهُمْ. As for those who have nothing except their hard earnings, فَيَسْخَرُونَ مِنْهُ. They balk at them and they cut jokes with them. سَخِرَ اللَّهُ مِنْهُمْ. Actually, Allah is mocking at them. The same verse that we have in Surah Al-Baqarah, second section. Allahu yastahzi'u bihim wa yamudduhum fi tughyanihim ya'mahoon. Actually, Allah is mocking at them. Walahum azabun aleem. For them is a very painful torment. Now, the harshest words, the hardest verdict, which is much more than the one which appeared in Surah Al-Nisa. What was it in Surah Al-Nisa? إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ فِي الدَّرْكِ الْأَسْفَلِ مِنَ النَّارِ. These munafiqeen, these hypocrites will be in the lowest part of Jahannam, lower than the kuffar. Here, Allah is telling Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, استغفر لهم أو لا تستغفر لهم. إِن تَسْتَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ سَبْعِينَ مَرَّةً فَلَنْ يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَهُمْ. You ask for forgiveness for them or you don't ask forgiveness for them. Be it known to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that even you ask forgiveness for them 70 times, Allah is not going to forgive them. ذَلَكَ بِأَنَّهُمْ كَفَرُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. This is because they have disbelieved, they have blasphemed, although not legally. Legally they are still Muslims. Only the veneer is there. Underneath that veneer, all wood had been eaten by the moth or the termite, whatever it is. ذَلَكَ بِأَنَّهُمْ كَفَرُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَاللَّهُ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الْفَاسِقِينَ. And Allah is not going to rightly guide these people who are transgressors, who are rebellious. فَرِحَ الْمُخَلَّفُونَ بِمَقَعْدِهِمْ خِلَافَ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ. People who were left behind, who were given the leave, okay, if this is, you know, this is the condition, you are in a very hard situation, if you can't go, okay, keep back, hold back. Now they were rejoicing, you know, that we could easily deceive Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَرِحَ الْمُخَلَّفُونَ بِمَقْعَدِهِمْ خِلَافَ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ. And they are sitting back after Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَكَرِهُوا أَن يُجَاهِدُوا بِأَمْوَالِهِمْ وَأَنفُسِهِمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. And they didn't like, they disliked to strive hard in the way of Allah with their bodies, with their lives and with their belongings. وَقَالُوا لَا تَنْفِرُوا فِي الْحَرِّ. And they said, don't go out in this heat. Look to the weather. It's so hot, scorching heat. You have gone crazy. You know, they were saying to their brothers, people, you know, who were related to them from among the Mu'mins, where are you going? You also go and you know, present a lame excuse. And Huwa Uzun, he is just, you know, years and nothing else. He will accept your apology. He will grant you leave. Why are you going in this scorching heat? And you have to traverse this whole area in this scorching heat. قَالُوا لَا تَنْفِرُوا فِي الْحَرِّ قُلْ نَارُ جَهَنَّمَ أَشَدُّ حَرَّ. Tell them, the fire of hell is most fierce, the fiercest in heat. لَوْ كَانُوا يَفْقَهُونَ. Would that they understand? Only if they had the understanding. فَلْيَضْحَكُوا قَلِيلًا وَلْيَبْكُوا كَثِيرًا. So they should laugh little and weep much. You know what is going to be their end. They should start weeping. Start right now. Jazam bima kanu yaksibun, being a recompense for what they have been earning. فَإِنْ رَجَعَكَ اللَّهُ إِلَىٰ طَائِفَةٍ مِّنْهُمْ فَاسْتَاذَنُوكَ لِلْخُرُوجِ. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes you, O Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, back to a party of them, that is, when you reach Medina back and if there is any another expedition in your lifetime, and if they fastazanuka lil khuruj, and if they ask your permission to go with you, go out. Because when they saw that, oh, even Heraclius, you know, he couldn't come forward. He held back. Muhammad came with flying colors, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So maybe that now, if another expedition, you know, happens in your lifetime, they will come, okay, we also want to go with you. فَإِنْ رَجَعَكَ اللَّهُ لَا طَائِفَةٍ مِّنْهُمْ فَاسْتَعْذَنُوكَ لِلْخُرُوجِ فَقُلْ لَنْ تَخْرُجُوا مَعِيَّ أَبَدًا وَلَنْ تُقَاتِلُوا مَعِيَّ عَدُوًّا. Tell them, oh no, you are not going to go out with me forever. You are barred. And you will never be fighting any enemy alongside with me. This thing is finished. Matter has been finished. إِنَّكُمْ رَضِيْتُمْ بِالْقُعُودِ أَوَّلَ مَرَّةٍ. You were pleased. You preferred to sit back the first time. Why this first time? This was the last time in the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Why first time? Because it was first time that going out to fight was obligatory. You failed. Before that it was not obligatory. It was voluntary. There was persuasion, exhortation of all the sorts, but it was not obligatory. That is why nobody needed to come and apologize and present his excuses that I can't go due to this reason, I can't go to this reason. And that is why those who held back without getting permission, you know, the explanations were not called. But we find that in Ghazwat Tabuk, after coming back, the Prophet called everyone and asked, why didn't you go? The explanations were called. So because this was the first time that going to fight, going to war, was made obligatory. When you didn't go, now it is finished forever. فَقْعُدُوا مَعَ الْخَالِفِينَ. Now keep sitting back with those who remain behind. وَلَا تُصَلِّ عَلَىٰ أَحَدٍ مِّنْهُمْ مَاتٍ. And now Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, never pray for any one of them when he dies. وَلَا تَقُمْ عَلَىٰ قَبْرِهِ. Never stand on their graves. إِنَّهُمْ كَفَرُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. They have blasphemed. They have disbelieved. They have rejected. وَمَاتُوا وَهُمْ فَاسِقُونَ. And they have died not as Muslims or Mu'mins, but actually as transgressors. وَلَا تُعْجِبْكَ أَمْوَالُهُمْ وَلَا أَوْلَادُهُمْ. And you should not be impressed by their wealth and their sons and daughters and progeny. Because these people loved this world, the life of this world. They were devoting all their time for earning money, burning money, gathering it, not spending it in the way of Allah. So they were rich. Well, a person who is devoting his time for the cause of deen, serving the deen of Allah, propagating the message, so he cannot have more time to earn. These people, they had more time. They loved wealth. And so they were rich. Now a rich man becomes prominent in the society. You know? And people look to him and listen to him whenever he says something. He's important. He's a wealthy person. He has so many heads with him. So many sons. So actually this was a very, you know, important matter at that time. In the tribal era. But, O Muhammad, you please don't get impressed. وَلَا تُعْجِبْكَ أَمْوَالُهُمْ وَلَا أَوْلَادُهُمْ. This ayah has been, you know, it came at ayah number 55 of this very surah, with a very, you know, minor, negligible difference. وَلَا تُعْجِبْكَ أَمْوَالُهُمْ وَلَا أَوْلَادُهُمْ. إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ أَنْ يُعَذِّبَهُمْ بِهَا فِي الدُّنْيَا. Actually, what Allah intends is, to give them the punishment on account of these very things in the life of this world. They will be tormented psychologically due to this wealth. Only a small loss and they can't sleep for so many nights. What is it? They are being tormented and chastised on account of their wealth. A son, and he has done this, he has gone, you know, in another direction. He is not taking to the direction which you wanted him to take. So he is a source of agony for you. So Allah intends to give him, give them this punishment in this world through this wealth and their sons. This is the punishment. وَتَزْحَقَ أَنفُسُهُمْ And Allah wants that their souls should go out of their bodies. They should die, وَهُمْ كَافِرُونَ In this very condition of kufr and unbelieving. وَإِذَا أُنزِلَ سُورَةٌ أَنْ آمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَجَاهِدُوا مَعَ رَسُولِهِ And when a surah is sent down, addressing the Muslims, have faith in Allah and strive hard with His messenger, side by side, strengthening him. اِسْتَاذَنَكَ الْأُلُ الطَّوْلِ مِنْهُمْ Now those who are resourceful, who have everything with them, they come to you to ask permission, to leave, to beg for leave. وَقَالُوا ذَرْنَا نَكُنْ مَعَ الْقَاعِدِينَ And they say, please just leave us. So we should be with the people who are sitting back, staying at Medina. رَضُوا بِأَنْ يَكُونُوا مَعَ الْخَوَالِفِ They preferred and loved to remain with the women who were staying back. Because, you know, this going to war was not obligatory for women. So women were staying back at Medina. They preferred to be with them. وَطُبِعَ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ فَهُمْ لَا يَفْقَهُونَ And now a seal has been set on their hearts. But they don't have any understanding. The real faculty of understanding has been taken away from them. A seal has been set. These words we'll find again repeated, you know, in Surah Al-Munafiqun. ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّهُمْ آمَنُوا ثُمَّ كَفَرُوا فَطُبِعَ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ فَهُمْ لَا يَفْقَهُونَ They did come to believe. They did taste, you know, iman. But then they went back. We have read that ayah in Surah Al-Nisa. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا ثُمَّ كَفَرُوا ثُمَّ آمَنُوا ثُمَّ كَفَرُوا ثُمَّ ازْدَادُوا كُفْرًا So that was the position. لَكِنِ الرَّسُولُ وَالَّذِينَ مَعَهُ On the contrary, the messenger of Allah and those who have the faith with him, who have come to believe with him, جَاهَدُوا بِأَمْوَالِهِمْ وَأَنفُسِهِمْ They strived hard with their belongings and their lives. مَوْلَائِكَ لَهُمُ الْخَيْرَاتِ And they are those for whom they are all good things from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ And they are those who will have the triumph, the final triumph, and they will prosper. عَدَّ اللَّهُ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا Allah has prepared and decorated for them the gardens underneath which rivers are flowing. And they will live there, stay there forever, forever. Zalikal Fadul Azim. And surely, this is the greatest triumph and this is the greatest success. Wajal Mu'azziruna min al-Arab. Now there were two types of munafiqeen. Up till now, the munafiqeen of Medina have been discussed. Now, a mention is being made of the munafiqeen from among the Arab. From the Bedouins. وَجَعَلْ مُعَزِّرُونَ مِنَ الْعَرَابِ لِيُوزِنَ لَهُ وَقَعَدَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا كَذَبُ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولَهُ And also, those of the munafiqeen came to you, وَجَعَلْ مُعَزِّرُونَ مِنَ الْعَرَابِ From among the desert Arabs also. People came to beg for permission and leave, not to go on this expedition. لِيُوزِنَ لَهُمْ وَقَعَدَ الَّذِينَ كَذَبُ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولَهُ And they also held back. And they just lied to Allah and His Messenger. سَيُسِيبُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ Very soon, to those of them who have really committed kufr, although not legal kufr, real kufr, for them there will be a very painful torment. لَيْسَ عَلَى الضُّعَفَاءِ وَلَا عَلَى الْمَرْضَى وَلَا عَلَى الَّذِينَ لَا يَجِدُونَ مَا يُنْفِقُونَ حَرَجٌ Is nasahu lillahi wa rasooli. There is no blame, haraj, blame. There is no blame on the weak, or the sick, or those who don't have anything to spend. Because they have to go to Tabuk. They need some animal to ride. Some camel, something of this sort. Two or three at least. They can join together in one camel, but they have to have some camel. But they don't have any resources. So these are the three conditions. لَيْسَ عَلَى الضُّعَفَاء وَلَا عَلَى الْمَرْضَى. No blame on the weak. Someone is too old to go. Okay, he's exempted. He's too old. Or someone is sick. Although he's young, but he's sick. وَلَا عَلَى الَّذِينَ لَا يَجِدُونَ مَا يُنْفِقُونَ حَرَجٌ إِذَا نَصَحُوا لِلَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. So long as they are sincere to Allah and His Messenger. Allah knows it. The battle is with Allah and He knows it. Who is sincere and who is telling a lie? Who is making lame excuses? وَمَا عَلَى الْمُحْسِنِينَ مِنْ سَبِيلٍ. Over such muhsineen, good doers, people who have their Islam in a beautiful way, who have reached that level of Islam, on them there is no way of blame. وَاللَّهُ غَفُورُ رَحِيمٌ. And verily Allah is forgiving, merciful. وَلَا عَلَى الَّذِينَ إِذَا مَا أَعْطَوْكَ لِتَحْمِلَهُمْ. In the same way, there's no blame on those who came to you so that you should mount them, you should provide them some animal to ride. قُلْتَ. When they came to you with this request, that I'm ready to go. I'm not sick. I'm fit. I'm ready to go. But please arrange, you know, some conveyance. قُلْتَ لَا أَجِدُ مَا أَحْمِلُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ. And you said, I don't find anything on which I can mount you. تَوَلَّوْا وَآيُنُهُمْ تُفِيدُ مِنَ الدَّمْرِ. They returned back and their eyes were overflowing with tears. حَزَنًا أَلَّا يَجِدُوا مَا يُنْفِقُونَ. Due to the grief that they don't have what they can spend. They don't have the resources. So these people, there's no blame. إِنَّمَا السَّبِيلُ عَلَى الَّذِينَ يَسْتَعْدِنُوكَ وَهُمْ أَغْنِيَاءَ. All the blame is to come to those people who beg your permission and leave, not to go with you. And they are, while they are rich, they are resourceful. They have everything. They can arrange the rations. They can arrange conveyance. رَضُوا بِأَنْ يَكُونُ مَعَ الْخَوَالِفِ. They were happy. They preferred it. They loved to be with those women who were left behind, who held back. وَتَبَعَ اللَّهُ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ. Again the same words. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has set a seal on their hearts. فَهُمْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Now they don't have the real knowledge. They are worldly wise. But this is not the real wisdom. The real wisdom is of person who knows that the real life is the life of the hereafter. They are worldly wise, very cunning. They can earn and they can see, they can deceive and they can do this. Everything, they are very worldly wise. But the real knowledge they don't have. يَعْتَذِرُونَ إِلَيْكُمْ إِذَا رَجَعْتُمْ إِلَيْهِمْ. They are presenting their excuses when you have returned to them. Now this is in plural. Because these people had to please their brother Muslims, you know, mu'mineen. Because now the mu'mins, the three mu'mins, they had now known that these people, they didn't go. And they knew it, that the excuses they presented were lame, baseless. So now they had to go to them also. Oh no, no, please don't be mistaken. Please don't doubt our sincerity. Actually, you don't know. This was the problem with me. This was the problem with me. And that was the hindrance. يَعْتَذِرُونَ إِلَيْكُمْ إِذَا رَجَعْتُمْ إِلَيْهِمْ. قُلْ لَا تَعْتَذِرُوا لَنْ نُؤْمِنَ لَكُمْ قَدْ نَبَّأَنَا اللَّهُ مِنْ أَخْبَارِكُمْ. O Muslims, you tell them plainly, although they might be your friends or relatives or so on, tell them plainly, we are not going to believe in you. Because قَدْ نَبَّأَنَا اللَّهُ مِنْ أَخْبَارِكُمْ. Allah has already informed us of your news. These, you know, ayat have been revealed. Now everything had been, you know, made clear for us. Now we can see through your game. So we are not going to believe in you. وَسَيَرَ اللَّهُ عَمَلَكُمْ. But okay. Now in future, in the times to come, Allah will see your deeds, what you are doing. Wa Rasuluhu, and his messenger also. Don't come to us. You have to please the messenger of Allah, and you have to please Allah. وَسَيَرَ اللَّهُ عَمَلَكُمْ وَرَسُولَهُ ثُمَّ تُرَدُّونَ إِلَىٰ عَالِمِ الْغَيْبِ وَالشَّهَادَةِ. Then you will be returned to him who is the knower of all the seen and the unseen. That is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَيُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. And he will inform you fully of what you had been doing. سَيَحْلِفُونَ بِاللَّهِ لَكُمْ إِذَا انْقَلَبْتُمْ إِلَيْهِمْ لِتُعْرِضُوا عَنْهُمْ. Very soon they will swear by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before you when you return to them. لِتُعْرِضُوا عَنْهُمْ. So that you just ignore them. You leave them alone. You don't bring them to task. You don't boycott them. They will love what they will like. فَعْرِضُوا عَنْهُمْ. Okay, O Muslims. You just leave them alone. You just ignore them. إِنَّهُمْ رِجْسٌ. They are wicked, wretched material. It's better to turn your faces from it. وَمَعْوَاهُمْ جَهَنَّمْ. And their abode is the hell. جَزَامْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. And it will be the recompense for what they had been earning. يَحْلِفُونَ لَكُمْ لِتَرْضَوْا عَنْهُمْ. O Muslims, they are swearing by Allah before you, so that you become pleased with them. You don't remain angry with them. You don't hate them. You don't boycott them. يَحْلِفُونَ لَكُمْ لِتَرْضَوْا عَنْهُمْ. فَإِن تَرْضَوْا عَنْهُمْ. Now listen. If you get pleased with them, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَرْضَى عَنِ الْقَوْمِ الْفَاسِقِينَ. Allah is not going to be pleased with such transgressors. الْعَرَابُ أَشَدُّ كُفْرًا وَنِفَاقًا. This is a very important issue now which is being discussed. And please note it here. Because regarding the misinterpretation of an ayah which is to follow, I have to refer to this ayah. الْعَرَابُ أَشَدُّ كُفْرًا وَنِفَاقًا. These Bedouins, these wandering Arabs, the desert Arabs, you know, two types of people were there. Settled in cities, Makkah, Medina, Yasrib as was called before Hijrah, Taif, Yambo, Jeddah, these were the cities. But you know, most of the people, you know, they were the desert Arabs. So, Al-Arabu Ashaddu Kufram wa Nifaqa. These, you know, Arab, these Bedouins, they are hardest in disbelief as well as hypocrisy. Why? It will become clear. وَأَجْدَرُوا أَلَّا يَعْلَمُوا حُدُودَ مَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ. And more likely, not to know the limits of that which Allah has revealed to His Messenger, عَلَىٰ رَسُولِهِ. وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ حَكِيمٌ. And verily Allah is all-knowing, all-wise. Why? Actually, because they didn't have time to spend with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Muslims at Medina, they had time. They prayed with him. They had the companionship. So actually, they were listening to his Friday sermons every week and on additional occasions. Then, different times, they were coming and meeting him and seeing him. So actually, this influence, you know, this barakah of the presence of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and this bliss of the suhbah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that was more available to people who were living in Medina. And these people, you know, they embraced Islam, but they were living in desert, far away. So they only, sometimes it happened that they visited Medina and they saw the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and availed of his presence. But you know, the degree was different. وَمِنَ الْعَرَابِ مَنْ يَتَّخِذُ مَا يُنْفِقُ مَغْرَمًا وَيَتَرَبَّصُ بِكُمُ الدَّوَائِرِ. And among these desert Arabs, there are people who take what they have to spend as fine. If they were made to pay zakah, oh, okay. But they took it as a fine. Because real belief, real iman was not there. They had to do it. Because now they had to embrace Islam. They had to pay the zakah. But they thought, you know, just you know, their emotions, you know, their sentiments were as if paying some fine. وَيَتَرَبَّصُ بِكُمُ الدَّوَائِرَ and they are waiting for some turn of events over you. There may come a turn of events and you Muslims may be defeated by some other force and then we are relieved of this fine, you know, which we have to pay every year. عَلَيْهِمْ دَائِرَةُ الصَّوْءِ On them will be the evil turning of events. There will be a turning of fortune and turning of events. But it will be evil for them. Glory is to come to Allah and His Messenger and Islam. فَلِلَّهِ الْعِزَّةُ وَلِرَسُولِهِ وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَلَكِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ وَاللَّهُ سَمِيعٌ عَلِيمٌ and Allah is all hearing, all knowing. وَمِنَ الْعَرَابِ But they are not all the Arabs. All the desert Arabs are not of that type. وَمِنَ الْعَرَابِ مَنْ يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ There are among them. Those who believe in Allah, have full faith, full iman in Allah, and the last day. وَيَتَّخِذُ مَا يُنْفِقُ قُرَبَاتٍ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ And he, whatever he has to spend, he takes them as if it is the means of getting nearer and nearer to Allah. So they spend heartily, willingly. Because these things, you know, these alms and charities and this zakah and this sadaqat will, you know, bring us closer and closer and closer, nearer to Allah. وَصَلَوَاتِ الرَّسُولِ And also, they will be a mean of getting the prayers and blessings of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. أَلَا إِنَّهَا قُرْبَةٌ لَهُمْ Let it be known that this is actually a means of getting nearer and nearer to Allah. All these, what they are spending for the cause of Allah. سَيُدْخِلُهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي رَحْمَتِهِ Very soon Allah will admit them to His mercy. إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ And verily Allah is غَفُور and رَحِيم. He is forgiving, merciful. وَالسَّابِقُونَ الْأَوَّلُونَ مِنَ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ وَالْأَنْصَارِ Now this, you know, part, a few ayat, beginning with this ayat, they are very important. They give us a classification of the Muslims at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And you must understand this classification because it has a psychological background. And you know, whenever there is some call, a movement, a dawah, a movement to establish Islam, you know, people's response will be parallel to the responses that are enumerated here. So to have a deep insight, just we had the ayah, وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ وَحَسُنَ أُولَٰئِكَ رَفِيقًا This is the classification. Four levels, four grades. Topmost, the Anbiya, the Prophets. Baseline, Salihin. In between, Shuhada and Siddiqeen. Most nearer to Anbiya are Siddiqeen. Then the Shuhada, and I explained that ayah at that time. And I have written an article also on this. Actually, these things are not fully understood by most of the translators and even the exegetes, even the Mufassireen. Because, you know, you have to have a background of psychology. Why these grades? What are the basic differences? What are the family, what are the personality structures? Which relate to these. So actually if you have that background, then you can fully understand who is a Siddiq and why is a Siddiq. Who is a Shaheed and why is a Shaheed. In the same way here, As-Sabiqun al-Awwalun, topmost. After them comes, Wal-Ladhina taba'uhum bi-ihsan. They are the uppermost two cadres. Then we shall find the lowermost, and they are the munafiqun. In between there are two levels. One which is adjacent to muttabi'een bi ihsan and one which is more adjacent to the munafiqeen. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 levels. There in that ayah we had 4 levels. فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ And also because, you know, this Nabuwah, prophethood, could not be attained It was always given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So actually there were three cadres. Because Nabuwa, it was Wahbi. It was never Iqtisabi. It couldn't be achieved. It was given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So three levels, Salihin, Shuhada, Siddiqin. Here we have five. وَالسَّابِقُونَ الْأَوَّلُونَ مِنَ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ وَالْأَنْصَارِ And the foremost, that is the first to embrace Islam from among the Muhajireen as well as Ansar. This is the topmost. وَالَّذِينَ تَبَعُوهُمْ بِإِحْسَانِ And those who followed them with the best of intentions, in the best way. Two cadres. Radiallahu anhum wa radu anhum. Allah has been pleased with them, and they are pleased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the highest corner, you know. Radiallahu anhum wa radu anhum. There can be no higher level than this. A mutual pleasure, mutual friendship, walaya. Allahu waliyu ladheena amanu yukhrijuhum min adh-dhulumati ila an-nur. Allah is their wali, protector and friend, and they are the protect. We are the friends of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the same way, mutual pleasure. Radiyallahu anhu wa radu anhu. But there are two cadres. Now this is the basic difference. You know, the level of strength of will, willpower, it is not equal in all the human beings. There's a very good, you know, couplet in Persian. Na har zan zanasto, na har mard mard. Khuda pan jangush yaksan na kart. Every woman is not a woman, and every man is not a man. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not made these five fingers equal. So actually there are differences. Allah has created people. So there are people who have strength. And power, powerful will. They are ready to sacrifice everything. There are others who wait. Let us see what happens. They recognize the truth. It is correct. But let someone else come first. If he plunges into this river, I will also plunge. But you know, they need someone going ahead. They don't have the courage to be the first. Because whosoever is the first is risking more. But when somebody has taken the initiative, now it appears to be a bit safer. But they have recognized the truth, all right. But they lack the courage somewhat. So they had to wait for some time. And they followed in their footsteps, in the footsteps of those who took the lead, who took the initiative. So these are the two levels, but both are at the highest. Because recognition of the truth, that came equally to the both of them. وَالسَّابِقُونَ الْأَوَّلُونَ مِنَ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ وَالْأَنْصَارِ وَالَّذِينَ تَبَعُوهُمْ followed them. They took the courage. They started. They took the initiative. Now, some people who are not courageous enough, equal to them, they also took the courage. Okay, when he's going, I can also go. رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ وَرَضُوا عَنْهُ Allah has been pleased with them, and they are pleased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَعَدَّ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي تَحْتَهَا الْأَنْهَارُ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared and decorated the gardens for them, underneath which rivers are flowing. خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا أَبَدًا And they shall live there, abide forever, forever. ذَلِكَ الْفَضُ الْعَظِيمُ Surely, this is the greatest success. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-Azim wa nafa'ani wa iyaakum bil ayati wa dhikri al-hakim.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.